To discuss the lecture, you know, August Mikhailovich not only beautifully presented, but also was right on time. Okay, we have the opportunity to ask questions to August.
Lin.
Так, microphone. We cannot hear anything without microphone. Sorry. You know, I'm going to give you some sad information. In the US, there is a registry, in a registry of cancer survivors, in adults and the children. Well, yeah, we're proud of our 5-year survival rate, but you know, only the very small proportion of young patients survive. So, you know, those who are younger than 40 or 30, even though, you know, the 5-year survival is good, but it depends on age. And it's good enough in children. As a result, and due to a number of circumstances, disease is dreadful by itself, and therapy is very cruel, and the surgery is debilitating. It's difficult to survive. I'm not even cautiously optimistic. You know, I never described like our successes, victories in pediatrics, domain of pediatrics. Please, more, you know, questions. Please ask your questions. Use the mic, please. Okay, the girl is bringing the mic. We would like to hear your opinion concerning combination immunotherapy with consideration of the fact that the mutations affect several genes. Okay, what about the combination immunotherapy? Is it promising or yes, it's promising, and something has been already, some combinations have been already developed and validated, but the situation is as follows. First and foremost, it's not a panacea. Immunotherapy is not a panacea. On the other hand, it may be prescribed for various types of cancers, like, you know, we're aware of 10 to 15 types of cancer that responded to combination therapy. But again, patients must be selected carefully. Those patients who have targets would respond. But I'm a proponent of the fact that in the future, you know, I would like to set up immunology units or immunology treatment units in cancer wards. You know, the immunotherapy recipients or candidates. I believe that that's our future, but it's very costly. It costs a lot. And the U.S. already tried this approach. Nonetheless, I believe that some combinations, you know, will be helpful. August Mikhailovich, you just mentioned to us that it's a new era of immunotherapy. Before that, it was like an era of chemotherapy. Before that, we had something else. But from your point of view, what's the future of pharmaceutical therapy, like a next step of it? It seems to me, the future drugs should be less toxic. I'm recollecting, you know, the Soviet Union and the very first drugs developed in the Soviet Union. I treated a patient from Bulgaria, and the patient, you know, came back to Bulgaria, a patient with Hodgkin disease. And basically, you know, upon his arrival, he gave 3 pills to his cat, and the cat died, and the patient refused taking anything. And in fact, you know, that drug Apgapan, you know, triggered vomiting, and that vomiting was worse than that caused by cisplatin. Nonetheless. Okay, the future therapy will be less toxic, and the surgery will be less debilitating. I'm pretty sure we cannot, you know, chase metastasis with a knife surgery. No, we cannot resect 5 organs for pancreatic cancer. You know, and how many patients treated in the US cured? Oh, no, 0.2% pancreatic cancer patient in the US got cured. I mean, survived for 5 years. 0.2%. And basically, after the extended resection, so viscera. Do we have more questions to August? August. You actually showed like awful, I mean, alarming slide. It reflects the growth of the rate, oncology rate. And how to improve our early diagnosis, like a screening, so we try to propagate the smoking cessation. And, you know, people are obsessed with healthy lifestyle. From your point of view, what this progress is associated with? Well, first and foremost, in life expectancy. Again, the US and the Japanese, 50% of women living now will turn 100. And of course, they're at risk of developing cancer. Everything has been calculated already. Those are, you know, basically, those numbers are comparable to those losses, you know, those World War II. And public health person should understand that it's the most important domain of health care. Yeah, our patients survive, but they become handicapped. And there are many young individuals in our audience, and it's their task to implement these advances to practice.